and sold out to him in the 21st century time. Oh, no, no, we're too busy. Help me, Holy Ghost. We're too busy with other stuff. Come on, somebody. But you're too busy, but you want God to move with you? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Yeah.
And these other things shall be added to you or provided for you. You got to put first thing first.
Amen.
I got to put first thing first. Putting everything in before God. God is a jealous God. Deuteronomy tells me he's a jealous God.
Yes.
He's jealous.
Yes.
He needs space to serve with all our heart, mind, and our soul. Amen. We can't have to expect God to move. And God's going to move because he's God.
Right.
But we don't get the full effects because we're not faithful.
Right.
We're doing the full effects because we're not committed.
All right.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Two little points, principles I want to pull out to you. And don't say the same about you now. Principle number one. When God desires to do great things for his people, he moves his people to great praise. Can I say it again? When God desires to do great things for his people, he moves his people to great prayer. That's principle number one. Principle number two is the timing of God, of God's answers to their prayer is often linked to God's purpose for his people as a whole. There's a purpose. I heard Dr. Stanley say, and I'm closing, he said, when I go through my trial, he said, I ask God, what's the purpose of it? Because God is up to something. He's up to something. And I found that personally in these 2 weeks. Something God is doing for me is to make me strong. Sometimes we think we're strong.
That's right.
Sometimes we think we're strong. We got it all together. But God will send something your way. And send your way for a long period of time. Buddy, you ain't as strong as you thought you were, buddy. Watch this. I don't care, Ray, that you are the pastor, God ever baptized in your church. You are never as strong as you think you are.
Yes. Yes.
And I have told you to go through some stuff in 2 weeks to let you know that you need more strength.
Yes.
You need more power.
Yes.
God has seen you through some stuff, you be crying and oh my goodness.
Yes.
And he'll send you by your all by yourself.
Yeah.
And he sends you by yourself on the journey because you don't get any instructions by self and people.
Yeah.
You say, God, you left it. And you know what the weird thing about to me? He don't say nothing for a whole 2 weeks. And then all of a sudden, God starts to have people come your way, speak a word in your life, and they don't even know who you are. They've never seen you before, but God will send them your way to speak life, to speak strength, to your spirit man. Then toward the end of the 2 weeks, God sent some people. One was alone, two of them were long distance. Call. One text, long distance. Two were local. God will do what he said he'll do. And the going through of the thing that we go through, you and I cannot lose hope.
Yes,
we cannot lose expectations.
Well.
It looks dark. It looks great. Yeah. You seem like you're all by yourself.
All right.
I'm going to be transparent.
All
right. I got to be briefly transparent on this part. Your support is gone.
Yes, sir.
This is the devil telling that. He said, that good support is gone. And you in the stand for 2 weeks. Now, what are you going to do now?
Well,
because what encouraged you is not all no longer with you.
Right.
Right.
Go on.
Right.
Go on.
What you going to do now? What you going to do now? When I get transparent to you, I got down.
Oh, yeah.
I got seriously down. And the devil, I'm saying so, he hear every word you say. And he will bring every word you say back to you. And I'm going to tell you exactly what he repeated to me. Y'all heard me say it a number of times. He said, now you down. He said, you make yourself laugh now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just trying to help somebody. I'm trying to help you through my experience. What are you going to do now? Can you make yourself laugh now? You ain't got nobody to help you. Well, can I have a brother or sister now? Oh, I got down for a minute. Not saying I got down for a little while. Because human nature kicked in. I don't give you a preacher, bishop, apostle, whatever. You going to human nature is going to kick in. And how long you let human nature stay there is up to you and I. Well, it's important to have the Holy Ghost. Y'all hear what I said? It's important to have the Holy Ghost. I got down for a while. Something about the Holy Ghost. Start to work it on the inside. Heard about a change on the outside.
All right.
And I said, all that change on the outside, just yesterday, what is it? I can't give it to that smile came back. That joy came back. That peace came back.
God.
I want to do what God says to do. Please Him. Let me say this. I keep hearing. I shared with somebody just the other day. I keep hearing Sister's voice. Send Raymond, do what God says to do. She said, don't you be distracted by people. You do what God says to do. And I hear that little voice just recorded in my mind when I don't feel like doing it. I hear a voice say, Raymond, do what God says to do. Lord, be my help. I'm going to do what God says to do. There may be somebody in the house who desires prayer. If there are such persons, will you come? Let us stand all over the church. Whatever you need, Lord, will you come? The Lord is here to bless you. Whatever you need, He is here to bless you.